Now, metallurgy is nothing but extraction of ores, right? So first of all, I'll give you the overall, you know, what we do for the extraction of any metals, right? So extraction of metals, it basically requires various steps, okay? So what are the steps we have to extract a metal from its ore? First of all, we'll select the ores, right? We'll select the ore first, from which ore we need to extract the metal. After this, we have another step. We call it as concentration of ores. Concentration of ores has nothing to do with the amount of the metal present in the ore. It is not related with the concentration of the metal, right? The amount of the metal present. It has nothing to do with that. The normal concentration term that we have, it is not related to that. Concentration of ore, or we also call it as dressing, right? Dressing of ores. The next step is this. Okay. Now for concentration, sometimes we'll do partial concentration. Sometimes we'll do complete concentration. Okay. So basically it involves the various steps. And if I write down here, we can have, leaching, the process that we use. We'll discuss this, what all this process we have. Leaching we can use for this method, or we can also do the separation. It is basically the separation of other metals. Okay, so when you get ore, after this we'll get concentration of ores, or we can also call it as concentrated ores. The ores that we get here is the concentrated ores. Okay, so what we do here, when you select the ores, we'll use here the various different methods to get the concentrated ores. Like we can use here, from here to here, if you go, we can use here flotation method. Flotation method. Basically, the objective in each step is what? We need to remove the gang, actually. Now, what is this gang? Gang is the impurity. G-A-N-G-U-E. Gang is nothing but the impurity present in the ore. Impurity in the ore, we call it as gang, right? So in the first step, when you select the ore by flotation method or by hand picking way, we can also pick those impurities which are very large in size easily, right? By looking at the ores, we can directly pick those impurities, right? So hand picking method we can also use, flotation method we can also use. We'll discuss in details what is flotation, leaching and all, right? So when you do this, you'll get concentrated ores, or this process we call it as concentration of ores, okay? Now after concentration of ores, we'll get, we'll again do here different process we use, and then we'll get impure metals. Impure metals, when most of the impurities has been removed, there are a few impurities which is present, we call it impure metals, okay? Now from impure metals, we'll eventually get pure, right? Pure metal. This is the overall thing we have, okay? Now to get pure from impure, the method that we use here, that there are various other methods like electro refining, zone refining, right? We can use here electro refining method. Electro refining, we can use zone refining, right? Concentration ores to get impure ores, we can use roasting. Roasting is one of the methods we have. We can also use smelting, we can use cancellation. Calcination, We can also use a reduction method. So the point I'm trying to make is what? To get from one to second step, if you want to go, there are different methods. And the method that we use depends upon what kind of ore we have. What is the property of the ore? According to that, we'll choose the best possible method. Okay. So this is basically the overall, process of extraction of metals we have. Right. So the extraction of metals. Involves various steps or various different processes. Okay, what are those processes that we'll see one by one now? I'll give you the brief idea of what we do. First, we'll select the ore. Then we use some flotation method and all to remove the larger, all those impurities which are large in size, which can remove easily, that we can do by flotation method and all. When you do this, you'll get concentrated ores. This process, we call it as concentration of ores or dressing of ores. So here we get concentrated ores. From concentrated ores, we'll get impure metal. How do we get impure metal? By these methods, roasting, smelting, calcination, reduction, impure metal, and then we'll get pure metal by electro refining or zone refining process. So now, what are these processes we have that we are going to discuss one by one? Okay, so extraction of metals involves various steps, right? The first step you write down here. The first step we have is concentration or dressing of ore. Okay. In this, you see the physical method of separation. Physical method. The first one we have here is gravity separation. Or we also call it as levigation. Write down this. Gravity separation or levigation. There are a few points which you need to keep in mind here. This method we use mainly for oxide ores. For example, SNO2, Fe2O3, etc. For oxide ores, we use this method. And this also requires the difference in density between ore and impurity. The overall method is, how do we use this particular method, gravity separation? For this, we have an inclined table like this. Okay, inclined table, and we have here an inlet of water. We can pour water from this side. Right? This is the water inlet. Here we have an arrangement by which we can put the crushed ore into it. Ore that we use, we crush that ore and that we put into this. Okay. Here we'll have an arrangement like this. It goes like this, and here we have raffles. This kind of arrangement of raffles we have here, right? This is raffles. In other language, you can understand this is a net kind of thing we have there. And here we have a beaker in which this complete solution goes from here. Right? So what happens in this process, you see, this is the inclined table we have. And there is an arrangement by which we can continuously stir this table. We keep on steering this table, right? Water flows from this side, ores we put here, right? So here we have a mixture of water and ores, right? And this mixture is, it is going down because it is inclined, it is going down, and we continuously stir this table, right? Table we are, continuously we are shaking the table here, right? Here we have gang with water, right? And since we need density separation, so what happens here, if density difference is there, then the continuous vibration of table results into the movement of lighter particles downward, and heavier particles are left behind. Okay, in the barrier. This is a net kind of thing in the raffles. So all those lighter particles that settles down when you stir the table from this mixture, that settles down, and heavier particles will be on the top of this mixture, and that is stuck into this raffles. Okay, and this lighter particles flows down into this beaker, right? So here we have the mixture of gang and water. Gang with water. This is the gravity separation process we have. Density difference is there. So we must have different force of gravity, and the one which has more force of gravity settles down, and that flows with water and get into this beaker that we have here. Right? And the heavier particles left behind in the barrier. Heavier particles left behind in the barrier, which is nothing but raffles. Okay, this is how it happens. Water flows this side, crushed ore from here, and then it flows down. Draw it. Let me know once you are done. Okay, done all of you? This is gravity separation process. The next one is magnetic separation. In this only, concentration of force only, the second method we can use here is magnetic separation. Magnetic separation. It is used for it is used for magnetic and non-magnetic impurities. Okay, the arrangement, if I show you, the arrangement we have here, we have two roller like this. And here we have connected with a tape like this. So you can see this is a roller or wheel or anything. I'm trying to draw this as good as I can. Here we have again an inlet through which we can pour crushed ore onto this magnetic plate, right? So what we do here, this is the inlet of ores. And this roller moves like this. In any direction it can move. So it goes like this. So when it moves, so obviously this goes in this direction and this goes in this direction. So continuously it goes like this. Okay. So we put a crushed ore here. And like I said, it contains magnetic and non-magnetic impurities, right? So this is a roller. It is a made up of some, you know, metals, which is attracted towards the magnet. Okay. So what happens here, this impurity, when it comes down to this the tape, so all those impurities which are non-magnetic that falls over here, and which are magnetic that sticks to this roller and falls somewhere here, right? So we'll have two beaker here, which collects these two impurities. So one is magnetic, other one is non-magnetic. Okay. So this ore, from this method, we can separate the two impurities of these two properties, right? And this ore, we call it as this, whatever we get here, we call it as concentrated ore. Concentrated ore. And this one is magnetic impurities. Got it? Done. Can we move to the next page? All these methods we are doing for this concentration of ores, depending upon the nature of the impurities, we can use any one of these methods. You need to memorize the first one that we use, gravity separation. We use that for oxide, ores of oxides, ores of oxygen. What is this magnetite? It's magnetic separation. Huh, the impurities will have this magnetic or non-magnetic impurities. You can say that. Okay.